Hey guys, I'm here with Tom from Line 6 Australia, and today we're talking about the HX Stomp XL, the new one.
The new one.
The big boy.
The slightly bigger HX Stomp.
Yeah.
So, this product was really born out of the idea of us existing HX Stomp users, which I believe you are as well.
Yeah.
And, you know, I've been using mine for a couple of years, gigging with it. It's been fantastic. We have 3 foot switches on the original HX Stomp, so in order to access some extra modes of the HX Stomp, people are adding on some extra foot switches. Could be via MIDI, or you know, just adding a simple two-button foot switch to add on some extra stomp modes. So this was born to expand that and have it as an all-in-one unit. So we now have basically 6 foot switches now on the left-hand side. So you can access those modes, and then a mode switch to access different modes such as snapshot modes or stomp modes. So you can get into a lot of those features directly from your foot now.
Yeah.
All the ins and outs of the original stomp are now on the back of the unit, which is great now. So obviously for pedalboard integrations, should you be using extra pedals or integrating it with your amp setup or however you're going to be using it, it now fits neatly onto your pedalboard with all the ins and outs on the back. And, it's not that much bigger than the original Stomp itself,
no.
If you look at it.
So the original one's probably like that size, right?
Probably exactly right, yes. So yeah. You have the 3 foot switches and then you have the display. The volume knob has now been moved to the back as well.
Yeah.
So to access the, you've got the screen and the menu modes.
I like that because I knock mine all the time.
A few people have, and the cool thing about this one is it's actually now a recessed volume knob. So you can actually set it in,
push it
in, and no one's going to kick it and change the volume, which, you know.
Thought of everything.
They have thought of everything in a real compact, still a very compact format unit.
Yeah, that's great. So one of the things that I was noticing when looking at some other videos of this is you can actually change parameters of effects like with your foot now, can't you?
Yeah, so that was another feature that was on the bigger Helix and the Helix LT.
Yeah.
But obviously we couldn't have access to that due to the nature of the amount of foot switches we had on the HX Stomp.
Yeah.
So now if you hold down the mode button, and if you see below it says edit or exit, but you can now do what's called foot pedal editing,
which
is a fantastic feature, so you can change any parameter in your effects chain with your feet. So often the downside of doing it with your fingers or something like that is you've got to obviously take your hands off the guitar, change something either on the computer via HX Edit or on the unit itself.
Yeah.
You can now sit there, keep playing, add a bit more gain or a bit more EQ and get the right sound whilst you're playing in real time, and then you can save it straight away.
That's so convenient.
What a great feature.
That's awesome.
And I've heard people even on the bigger Helixes doing that during gigs, when they've gone, oh, I wish I had that a little bit louder. And they're playing, smiling to the audience. Just change that gain up a bit.
Because it's pretty hard to do that with your JMP, like while playing.
Well, obviously, that is a harder thing there to kick your amp and get the volume or get that little bit higher treble thing in the live scenario. And you can access that now via foot, which is a great feature.
That's awesome.
And then obviously you also have your tap tuner button on the right hand side as a completely separate foot switch as well. So it doesn't infringe on the stomp mode or snapshot mode. So it's a really cool unit.
That's awesome. So I was just thinking when you were explaining that, I don't envy your job. These things are so like incredibly complex.
Yeah.
You've got to think about all of the things that, are possible with this.
Absolutely. And with the integration now of Command Center, which for you guys that do a lot of MIDI work as well, you can now assign any foot switch to send, say, it could be a MIDI command on top of what you're pressing as a stomp mode. And that was integrated in the recent 3.0 update as well, even for the HX Stomp.
Yep.
But obviously you've got 3 foot switches to do that. Now you've got the extra foot switches now on the unit, so you can control an awful lot more just from this single unit, which is a really cool feature.
That's great. One of the reasons that I bought mine was like, you know, being a musician in Australia, you've got to fly everywhere, like, most of the time.
Absolutely.
So, you know, even just to get to Sydney, for instance, you got to jump on a plane. So to have something that's, like, you know, as compact as this, and, you know, you can use it as an amp, you can use it as just an effects pedal.
That's right.
It's all in the one thing. It's so handy.
And, you know, when you fly to different gigs, you're not always sure exactly what gear you're going to get.
Yeah.
You know, and it might be even just an amp, and you're using it just as an effects process for that time, but should the amp die at a, you know, at a gig, which, you know, it's all happened to us, I'm sure, at some point.
Yeah.
You can then just use the amp models directly from here, direct to the PA.
Yeah.
So you've got your backup amp rig, which is a fantastic, you know, feature. But then also, you know, as I said, if you just want to use it in front of your amp as well with some effects, you can do that as well and integrate it as a full cable device. So you've got a massive amount of flexibility from the single unit.
Yeah.
You know, and as you say, going to gigs around, you know, around the country, if you need to fly something you can just chuck in your bag that doesn't, you know, doesn't take you over that weight limit by any stretch of the imagination.
Yeah,
you know?
It saved me big time. When I did this tour in Europe a couple of years ago, and we were in the UK and then had to fly to Amsterdam for one show.
Yeah.
And we're like, oh, it'll be right, we'll borrow the other band's, you know, backline or whatever. And I show up and the other band's like, no, we've got like real specific, you know, settings and stuff. So I was like, no, and ended up just plugging in the HX. It was awesome. It was fine, totally fine.
I mean, the quality, obviously, as you know, the amp models and the effects now, they're even just, you know, built in, are phenomenal.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, we're very lucky as guitarists in this day and age to have, you know, such a broad range of products that we can choose.
Yeah.
You know, and, you know, should you have your particular, you know, special effect, you know, or special distortion pedal you've had custom built from you, you know, you can integrate it in this with a simple send and return, you know, and build that into your chain. So, you know,
how do you do that?
So now on the back here, we've got a stereo send and return.
Mm-hmm.
So on the back here, we've got a stereo send and return.
Right.
So you know, you can build in some extra pedal chains, which is fantastic, you know, and it does happen, you know, I mean, you know, these were never designed to replace everything that you, you own. It's designed to be, you know, I personally don't add anything with mine when I'm using it. I don't require that.
Yeah.
But there are plenty of players that say they have their particular, you know, might be a particular effect or a particular distortion pedal they absolutely love, and that's their, you know, that's core part of their sound.
Yeah.
So you can integrate that as in, you know, in the pedal chain as well.
That's so cool.
And a recent update for HX Stomp users is we've now got 8 blocks to use, one of the recent 3.0 update.
Okay.
Previously we had 6 blocks, and now obviously the HX Stomp XL also has the 8 blocks.
So does this have a different processor then as well?
No, so we've got exactly the same sharp processor, exactly the same kind of architecture, I suppose.
Yeah.
Hence, you can import all your existing presets in. One great addition, I think, for the XL as well, we now have 4 snapshot modes rather than 3 on the HX Stomp.
Okay.
So that's a really cool feature. And for those who don't know what snapshots are, it's within a chain. You obviously sometimes want to maybe turn on 2 effects, or you want to then increase the gain of your distortion pedal and the level, plus add a bit more compression. You can do that from a single foot switch control of, you know, within the HX Stomp.
Another thing that's tricky with the JMP.
Another thing, if you want to turn, and you know, from using individual pedals sometimes, you've got that kind of tricky, you know, side stomp of 3 pedals to turn on. You can do that with a single foot switch and you can program that into your HX Stomp, which
that's
I love.
Cool.
It's a really versatile unit.
That's really cool. One question that I had for you as well. So when you've got it just set up as like the normal kind of block chain, can you use these as blocks as well, like it switches for blocks, or is it just cycling?
Yeah, so that what's great now is you can actually choose between 4 stomp mode or 6 stomps, so you can actually utilize all syncs as a stomps, if that's, you know what I mean, within, which is generally within an 8 block chain, that's probably majority of what you're going to be turned individually on and off.
Yeah.
Or you can separate them out and still have preset up and down on the left hand buttons.
Yeah.
And then you can access snapshot mode via holding the 2 left up and down buttons together.
Yeah.
And that accesses enters snapshot mode for you.
And you can still expand this with another foot switch anyway.
And absolutely. I mean, you've still got the MIDI in and out option. So, I mean, again, if you set up particular things via MIDI, you can still utilize that as well, or add an external, volume pedal, you know, to access the expression effects, or add another 2 button foot switch even for even more, you know, so if you wanted all 8, I suppose.
Yeah.
But you know, for me, there's enough on there, I think, per preset now for you to not have to add a huge amount.
Yeah.
But obviously, if you're doing some more complex things via MIDI within part of your, integrated as part of your show, then yeah, absolutely all of that can be integrated with the HX Stomp XL.
That's so cool.
It's excellent for that.
I think that's pretty much all of the new stuff, isn't
it? Yeah.
Yeah. So do you want to go through some sounds?
Yeah, so what's cool, I think recently we had a big update for the Helix. I think probably one of the biggest updates we've had for certainly maybe even a year, over a year, which was the 3.0 update, which added, I suppose, a fairly comprehensive poly pitch effect,
yeah,
which, you know, are really useful for a lot of guys. You know, that was often things that people could, you know, wanted to add on maybe to the previous Helix range was a poly pitch. So that means that basically when you're playing a chord, you can now pitch shift those whole things,
yeah,
you know, with one, you know, pedal, I suppose, if you know what I mean.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
One button can now, you can change basically the chords down a tone or something, yeah, which I'll demonstrate on a patch. Or what's cool here, which I love, is this particular patch here, I've actually used the pitch shift. Instead of it being a sort of a broad sort of gliss or, you know, via a foot pedal, you can actually use some very subtle effects here. So what I'm going to do here is play.
Can I ask you one question just quickly before I start? I know this girl, and she has like this crazy setup, right? Mm. She's got like a whammy that's running to one amp, but it splits before that. So her signal comes out of the guitar to a splitter, and then one side of it goes to just a one guitar amp, and then the other side of it goes to another guitar amp, and there's a whammy on that chain, and she pitches that up a fifth or a third, depending. Yeah. So it's like a harmony on that end. Is it possible to put harmony just to one output?
Yeah, so you could split the chain. The HX Stomp, rather than the Podgear, so the HX Stomp splits the chain and you could send that to left and right. So you come out the left and right and then.
Yeah.
As a dual amp setup.
Because one of the things that that I've thought about a lot with mine, and like one of the things that I don't think many people have really spoken about online before, is like for two, like a duo style setup, like Royal Blood, or you know, one of those big sounding duos. You could kind of like really utilize this for that, like have like a bass sound on one side.
Yes, you could. You only got obviously 8 blocks though, so a bass would be fine because you've only used a preamp and a cab sim, you know, and then maybe have a bit more for the guitar almost like. But absolutely, you could plug into the left, you could plug into the effects return with one input as an input.
So you can have, so it's 8 blocks even if it's split into 2 chains. Right, okay, cool. Interesting.
Whereas the Helix, obviously that's more useful for that because you can actually have 4 chains on that.
Yeah,
so
okay.
You can run the whole band through.
Yeah, right. Wow, that's super cool. Yeah. All right.
That's interesting. Right. So I think we'll get my foot into the thing. So.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so what I've done here is I've set actually just a semitone detune on a momentary foot switch via the pitch shift to create. I mean, I've got a whammy bar, I haven't got my, on my guitar here. So I've left my whammy bar at home. Oh, I want to do those little nice little glissando kind of things. But now I can do it via this nice little momentary pitch. Super smooth, and if I play, obviously that's single lines, but I could do even on a chord. And because it's poly, you know.
Some pedal steel kind
of vibes, you know. And you know, I know a lot of guys, you know, say, certainly with fixed bridge guitars, you know, sometimes want to access that type of effects, and obviously, you know, well, hang on, we can't just drill into my guitar and add a bar sometimes.
Yeah.
But you can access that now via this. So that's one of my favorite new features, which I love it, and it's very subtle.
Yeah, it's great.
This one's really cool. This is another effect using the poly mode. So what this actually acts is I can play a chord and it sustains the chord behind me.
Oh.
And I can play over the top.
Cool.
But what's very cool about this is because it's in poly mode, I can actually pitch shift the background chord.
Oh.
So I'll show you. So I've done that via snapshots.
So like a freeze, but you can change the chord.
Yeah, so this is really cool. So anyway, so we'll have a go at this and we'll see how we go. Thank you. my snapshots, I've got the chord playing.
That's hilarious.
There you go.
I love it. Just firing keyboard players.
I know. It's a terrible thing. But hey, what can you do, you know? It's a great feeling. And obviously, you know, if you're practicing, it's great, you know.
Yeah.
But great for effects alone. A live show, you've got access to that type of effect. Yeah. But to be able to poly pitch it is unbelievable.
Yeah, that's wild. And you just did pretty much all of that with your feet as well.
I'd say because of the nature of the setup that we've got here and the camera overhead, had to a little bit of work, but yes, you can do obviously access that all from your feet as well.
That's brilliant.
Really cool. So one of the new models that was on the 3.0, which is in turn I think becoming a favorite for a lot of players, is the US Princesses, which is based on the Princeton.
Okay. Yep.
Which is an awesome sounding amp. So, and then I've got a couple of added effects before and after which are really cool, but let's just hear the, it's got the Princeton. Beautiful.
We did a video the other day with my friend Greg from Press Club,
yes,
local band,
okay,
and he runs a Silverface Princeton, but he does a split. So on stage there's a Silverface Princeton, and then to the front of the house he runs that Princeton. So yeah, he's splitting out of that.
There you go. That's praise indeed of how good it is. One of my other favourite was actually the Horizon Devices Drive, which. I believe, look, I wasn't that familiar with the effects pedal myself, but I believe it was used more in the heavier markets.
Right.
But it actually works awesomely in front of a cleanish amp like the Princeton.
Yeah.
It's a very responsive drive, so. Just because I suppose things have been utilised within, you know, other maybe musical genres, doesn't mean you don't have to use them within, you know, other amps as well. So I discovered that. I thought, that's a beautiful sounding drive, and you know, it will sit in with a lot of different musical styles.
Yeah, that's cool.
Now, and the other sort of one of my favourite effects that was added was this thing called a glitch delay, which. It's very hard to explain. I think the only way to do it is just play something and then you go, right. And you'll probably still go, I'm not quite sure what's going on here, but it's just, it's incredible. I love it.
Yeah. That's great.
So there's a variety of controls on there, such as octaves, reverses, and it basically does a kind of semi-sample and hold, I suppose, of different, you know, parts of that, and then shifts them randomly, and you can select how random you want it, how patterned you want it like that. That's more of like, I suppose, like an arpeggiated pattern.
But you
can make it weirder and even odder than that. But it's an experimental delay that you will have you sitting there for a long while and get lost in the ether.
Yeah.
You know, you put your headphones down and an hour later you go, oh, what happened there?
Yeah.
The glitch delay is the time.
Really fun. That's cool.
I love that. So, moving on.
Let's move on to...
Now, this is a very fun...
I've always been a big fan of Line 6 delays, ever since the DL4.
The DL4, which, I mean, is an incredible, you know, longevity, I suppose, out of a unit, you know, that's, I think, celebrated its 20th birthday.
Yeah, I miss mine all the time. I saw it a couple of years ago. And
it's a pedal that still comes up on so many pedal boards of the pros.
Yeah.
You know, it's got an organic sound that just... his heart to be replaced, you know, and so, yeah, I know, I love the delays, and they're moving forward with things like this glitch delay. It's great,
you know,
and to have kind of, I suppose, slightly more unique effects specific to the HX family, you know what I'm saying. Now, coming back to the poly pitch, this is my cheat guitar to how to play guitar. So on the snapshots here, I've actually set the pitch shift to go to, I suppose, different pitches. So it's gonna essentially capo my guitar up and down, virtually, with a foot switch control, which for you guitarists out there, you know, maybe chords are too much, moving your chord around. So anyway, we'll have a bit of fun. So here's my E chord. And I'm also utilizing the new diesel amp here, which sounds crazy. So for the chuggers, this is one for you. So if you look at my left hand, I'm going to be playing an E chord throughout this whole piece. So here we go.
That's ridiculous.
it's a crazy world.
Yeah.
Hey, why play four chords when you can play one?
Yeah, and also one-arm guitarists are going to be super stoked about this.
I can just play open string and just play. So,
that's brilliant.
Yeah.
You did a great job of dodging our tripod.
I did. It's with the tripod in the way.
Yeah.
And obviously, I mean, utilizing that effect, I mean, you know, just as a simple, I suppose, for the guys that maybe have, you know, seven strings or such like, or maybe they only utilize that for maybe a couple of tracks, you know, and obviously investing in a separate guitar for those tracks can be a bit of an investment.
Yeah.
So you could obviously just pitch it down a fifth and just go, or fourth, or whatever you want it to, you know, and just play it.
Sweet.
There you go.
Sweet.
Just pitch shift your whole guitar down and you're in seven string mode for a portion of the song. Don't have to change anything.
Yeah.
And then you're back to the rest of the track in normal tuning if you want to, which is unbelievable. And the tracking's, you know.
Yeah, it doesn't have that digitally thing that I remember that, what's it called? The big silver drop tune pedal from like a couple of years ago.
Yeah, okay.
I can't remember the name. Anyway.
But yeah.
I'll put it here.
You'll have it here and then say, remember that one?
But I remember that you'd pitch down with it and it would have like this kind of digital artifact kind of sound to it, and it would also really struggle with chords.
Yeah.
But that, can you just play like an E minor?
Yeah.
With that and just... Tracking's
it's,
insane, hey?
It's crazy. I mean, from people I've spoken to and in the forums out there, I mean, a lot of people have said it's as good, if not better, than anything else that's out there on the market in terms of its pitch shifting capabilities. I mean, I agree. I don't feel any latency when I'm playing, which I think has been the issue with some other units.
Yeah.
Or it feels very natural as if I'm just playing. I mean, you've obviously got to then remember where you are. You know, something, you're not playing an E chord, you're playing a B chord or something like that. So,
yeah.
your musical brain has to think a bit sometimes, but yeah, it's so versatile. I love it.
That's great.
It's really cool.
Wow.
And I suppose the last effect, which I'm just going to show them, there's a lot more to dig into, but you know, obviously we have limited time to hear this.
Yeah.
And this is going to be...
You might be able to hear a small dog grumbling in the background.
Not a fan of acoustic Sims, apparently.
Oh, well, don't you play that acoustic Sim.
I'm in trouble. But a really cool, again, probably another feature that, you know, I think people often added on, you know, was an acoustic Sim pedal. Because, again, sometimes for certain a portion of the track, you know, you just need that type of acoustic sound, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
And we're not, you know. We all know from acoustics, it's not going to replace a real acoustic, you know, on that nice intimate setting.
Yeah.
But honestly, if you're singing in a track.
Yeah.
And then, just to quickly show you another little poly pitch effect that we added, which was the 12 string model, which now I've got.
It sounds really nice. Yeah. I don't know if it sounds exactly like an acoustic guitar, but like, you know, it does sound like a very usable tone.
The whole point is, and you know, again, everyone's going to tweak it. And
yeah,
the thing about acoustic Sims is, if people have used them before, is obviously it's going to be depending on the pickups that you use and how, you know, what a bit of EQing you use. But you've got access to a lot of parameters. But to me, in terms of that sound in a track in a live scenario, I wouldn't be, you know, sitting there going, oh, that's a terrible, you know, or what's that sound? It's very convincing, and convincing enough certainly in that scenario to utilize, which I think is it's a crazy little unit, you know. And as I say, that's touching the surface of just a few of the 3.0 update effects that we have. But I think it highlights, I think, you know, the amount of work that goes into keeping, you know, a product fresh for existing users, or, you know, attracting new users to the product as well, because... You know, maybe some people held off going, oh, I wish it had poly pitch effects. Well, now we can say, yes, it does, you know, or something like that.
I think just the extra buttons are like, when I saw this come out, I was like, oh my God, there goes all my money again.
I know. I mean, same here. I'm thinking this probably will be, you know, the next one on the list.
Yeah.
And, because as a user, as I say, particularly, I mean, you know, bring an extra foot switch, so now I don't have to, because it's all inbuilt. And, and to access all the modes of snapshot mode and, as I said, stomp mode, to add preset up and down, a tap tuner, all from, you know, without having to do anything else, it's all built in, I think is a really, really good idea. And I think it's really going to attract certainly either existing users, or, you know, for new users to this. I think it has now the best of both worlds in a very compact format.
Yeah, if I think about the way that, like, I use gain stages personally in like a songwriting way as well.
Mm.
Like, you often have like a rhythm sound for your verses.
Yeah.
And then you want to step up a tiny bit for your choruses. So that's two buttons gone there.
Yes.
And then you've got, you know, your third button for your solo.
Correct.
And then maybe you've got a feature sound as well in there. Like a delay that comes on and off. Like, that's, you're already running out of buttons on the normal HX.
Yeah.
So, yeah, when I saw this, like, come onto the market, I was kind of like, oh, that answers all of the problems that I
had. Actually, I mean, funnily enough, I set my patch up, you know, off my go-to gig patch in a very similar way. I've got two gains.
Yep.
I've got a clean boost, kind of level boost, I suppose, plus a delay, and maybe even a modulation on and off. So I need access to kind of five things, but then also I don't have my tap tuner, then I have to sacrifice one of the buttons for that.
Yeah.
But now I've got it all here. I've got the, you know, the tap tuner and then six stomps, which is, you know, probably, you know, how I would use it more in my, for me personally.
Yeah.
You know, but then quickly go to snapshots if I need to do any more complex, you know, parameter changes within a patch.
Yeah. That's so handy.
That's great.
So handy. I bought this Fender Tone Master here because it only weighs 10 kilos.
Yep.
And sometimes, you know, you go overseas and you end up in like playing some terrible little venue.
Yeah.
Which are always the best venues.
Yeah, they are.
But like often the PA can be a little bit cooked.
Yes.
You know, and you've got like two channels that work on the desk or whatever.
I know it well.
Yeah. So sometimes, you know, you can't just plug this into the PA.
No.
You know, so I bought this ToneMaster. Mm. And the great thing about this that really excites me is that will fit in the back of that amp.
Okay, yeah, that's cool.
And then you put like, you know, just a little bit of Velcro on the bottom of that, a little bit of Velcro on the bottom of the cab.
Yeah.
Put them both, you know, in a suitcase and the whole thing can go on because you got the 30 kilogram limit,
you have,
you know, on international flights. So that's like an entire rig.
So powerful.
Yeah.
So powerful. I mean, you could do, you know, as many gigs, I think, as mostly required, I think, with,
totally,
you know, what you've got built in there, which I think is a, as I said, it's a testament to how powerful, I suppose, a simple, you know, compact unit like this can be.
Yeah.
You know, it's incredible.
Yeah, exactly.
Know? And remember, you can also run, you know, stereo paths if you want to on the HX Stomp, if you want to get a bit deeper into it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, there's plenty of things to access at a deeper level with something even this small, you know. And remember also, the USB out is a 24-bit 96K USB interface. So you can record directly out of here. So, you know, if you're on the road, particularly great, if you've got a little computer, just plug this in, that's your recording interface sorted as well.
With a whole library of amps built into
exactly
it.
Exactly right. Yeah. You know, so anything you record, you can then, you know, if it sits well, you can just take it from there straight out with you and you've got your sound at your feet.
It's brilliant.
It's crazy stuff.
All right. Well, thanks so much for coming in today.
Absolute
talking
pleasure.
To you about this is a really, really exciting thing.
Yeah.
And yeah, we'll hopefully get you back again soon when the next amazing product is released.
There's always more things to talk about and always happy to come and see you guys. So,
yeah.
Fantastic.
All right, thanks. Like and subscribe to our channel. We're going to put out heaps more videos just like this one, so stay tuned. See you later.
See you.